Hey, we're gonna do a little bit of sawing some cedar today. Kevin's on his way to get my camera holder. Just made one cut on this log. I gotta make some 3-inch by 4-inch pieces for my neighbor. He's wanting to put a, make it look like in his house he's got beams going across the ceiling. Some of y'all new subscribers ain't gonna know. This is my sawmill. I bought this several years ago. I had it over a decade. It's a Wood Miser LT40 hydraulic, really modified. Number one modification, it has an electric motor. Runs on 15 horsepower three-phase electric motor. Number two modification, hydraulic saw blowed up on me, so I fixed it up with a 220-volt motor, turned the hydraulic pump, changed the valving and everything to make it work. So we'll make you a little video. Thank you. Of us sawing some. Try to set you up down here on my old sharpener table so you can see what's going on. Kinda. Made four of them. Those go right there where you're standing, so. Ain't them pretty? We want to stack them flat down, so. Makes it a hair easier to not tip them over. Maybe. You want to stack them with the flattest side down there. You're standing on edge right now. There you go. Now you got it. I can say what I mean, but I don't know that everybody can understand what I mean when I say what I mean. You ever do that? What?
Kind of know what hear,
say
to me when I can't hear what to say or what to mean.
Huh? Yeah, Kevin's favorite thing is to say, huh? So I just say, blah, 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 get him to listen to me, and then I tell him what I want him to know. I learned that years ago with my dad. Let me see if I can get this back first. I won't have to go up so stupid high. That one's kind of got a bad spot in it, but I think it'll all trim off. This sawmill is pretty simple. The hydraulics all run off two levers. This one's a tow board. This one right here, this runs your clamp in, you're out. And the other way is the turner and backstop. So, kind of got to get it to where that thing is about. And then you got to make sure everything's out of the way. Anybody can run this, it doesn't take no super big skill, but it takes a little home to get at it. Hey, my blade tension's gotten loose. These controls, this one forward and back with the head. This one is your forward feed rate speed. This one controls your arm in and out. And this one is the head up and down. Got a tape manager right there. So all you gotta do is know exactly where the next cut needs to be and just set the head to go. Sounds easy, don't it? I'm gonna set you up back behind me to get a little video from that side. I think you're all right.
That way, can I?
How about with my finger in front of it? Will that work?
I believe that right there would be perfect.
know if you can see anything down there. You guys doing all right? Most of it. Still a bark seam.
Right out there it looks.
We have to take another board off that side. What I'm aiming for is to get a 6x8 and then split it on both sides in half. So that cut was on 8, maybe a little 7. If we roll him over, it'll be golden. They get one more board off the next side. I usually get into a deal like this, and after I cut some of them, the customer comes up and says, "Well, I wanted them not have any knots in them. I wanted them to be all red." I didn't say that when I started this. Going down to 6. when you get these, it's like this, they never turn. So what I do is I use Kevin. Here, I have to flip them down by hand. That probably worked better than a hydraulic turner anyway. Except when he gives me that funny look. Ain't your equipment working right?
Could have grunted.
Yeah, he didn't grunt even on that one. Sometimes he would grunt and look at me like, you didn't even give me the can hook. I gotta split them in half for this three. They were already six. Guy told me he needed like 350 linear feet of these, and I figured it up, and if everything made as much as I thought it might make, that I have, I'd get about half of that. But he didn't seem worried. He's like, oh, I think you'll come up with some other, finish it. Sit down a minute. So, I'm gonna shut the big motor off. So those three befores that are 10 foot are 10 board foot apiece. Since anybody, let's say lumber's really, really high, well, stuff at the sawmills went up some, but so that means those cost either $15 or $18 a piece. If we quit now and have made a day's wages, we're only half hour into this, maybe. That'd be nice, wouldn't it? Well, anyway, thanks for watching. I'll catch you on the next one. I'd already shut it off. Well, we got more than I thought we would then. If those are 10 foot, are they 10 foot? You got 24 of those three befores made. And, 1, 2, 3, 4 layers of lumber.
Yep.
How about that? We only really need 11 more of them then. Huh. We might be able to come up with logs to do that. I bet there's some of them down at Tommy's, don't you think?
Yep.
We just have to go find them. Of course, right now we can't do much of nothing else because it's so stupid muddy. Anyway, hey, yeah, you walk in there and then carry them out on our shoulders. It better pay better than $1.80 a board foot to carry it out on my shoulder, buddy. Hey, thanks for watching. Y'all have a good one.